Hey guys, you're watching because you want to know Lee. My name is AJ. Welcome back to another episode of Let's Build a City. We're back over at the sort of industrial part of our world today because I want to build another factory right in between our beach houses and what I'm calling the ice cream factory. What city isn't complete without an ice cream factory? We've got it was meant to be an ice cream factory, but then we put some vans outside and the vans have not just ice creams written on the side of them. So I was like, okay, it's an ice cream factory. These two vans aren't meant to be parked that way. They were parked the other way in the spaces, but as I've loaded up the game a few times, I think like if the cars are too close to a block, the game doesn't quite remember exactly where they were, so it just places it like close to where it remembers that they were, something like that. I don't really know, but they're facing the wrong way. Doesn't really bother me that much. But yeah, I want to do a factory in here to fill up this space. It's really cool because we've done this whole world by doing buildings sort of spread all over the place and sort of working out roughly where districts are, you know, housing districts and nightlife districts and skyscraper districts and stuff like this. But now we're starting to sort of bridge the gaps between everywhere and everything's all starting to connect into one. It's really exciting to see. But if this factory does end up being large, relatively large like this one, I think floor space wise it's probably going to be a little bit bigger. And if it does go into the ocean at all, you know, if we keep it in line with this one, it might end up going over the water. We're not going to worry. There's two options that we can do. Number one would be quite simply to make the ocean a little bit, or the beach a little bit larger and sort of go down there and join up. Not a problem at all. Making the beach larger is easy and wouldn't look bad whatsoever. Option number two is to actually make the edge of the factory go into the ocean and actually have that part of like an ocean wall, like a barrier wall. I don't know. I'm really unsure. Like, for example, I don't want this going straight into sand. I don't know what I'm going to do here. I don't know if I'm going to put in like a sea wall like we have on the cargo port and continue that down behind here and change this to grass. But the last thing I want is it just going from like grass to sand where the factory is. It just makes no sense, and you'd get grit in the ice cream and then the ice cream would taste horrible and it would be terrible, wouldn't it? With this factory though, I want to have it in a little bit of an L shape if I have the room for it all. I'm just going to grab some blocks that I know we're likely going to need. We're going to be using the same sort of blocks. It would just make a lot of sense to sort of keep the old style factories with the same sort of color palette. It's definitely going to be bricks at the very least. But it's going to have some big chimneys coming off. I've got a rough design on sort of what I want. I don't think I want it connected, but I want it close enough to look like it's all meant to be sort of part of one. And I think we want something like this. Is that a little bit too far back? That might be a little bit too far back. We might have to bring it forward a little bit. Keep it out of the way of this roof. And if that was like the front, I think that could work out pretty well. So I don't really know exactly where I'm going with this yet. It's going to take a little bit of sort of fiddling around to get exactly what I want. But I think I want something like this, and then it drops back to a garage door here, which is going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 blocks wide. And then it goes back out to bricks again. I think something like this, and then I want it to come out again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Lag spike. And then come back in to that one again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. How close are we? Oh, I've got loads of room. Okay, I was really concerned that I would look up and the wall to the house would be right there. I'd be like, oh no, I don't want that to happen. And then we want to do the same thing. If I can get three garages in, that would be really nice. I want to make sure that I'm good spot, AJ. Well done for checking. Oh, that would have been really annoying later on. Okay, yeah, that's better. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, how bad would have that been if we had gone like all the way through it and then found out that that block was one out? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I'm sure something would have given it away a little bit earlier, but yeah, it's always good to catch it. Okay, so I've got the three garage doors, and then I want this to be a little bit of an L shape, so I want the building to come out here somewhere, and maybe even touch the path of the road. I think that would be cool to be walking down and then have, like, the brick come near it. Something that you rub your hand against. Am I the only one that does that? I can't be the only one that does that when I'm walking next to a brick or a stone building. I always rub my fingers down. It's such a bad thing to do. But I can't help it. It's just like something that I have to do. Okay, I think I want to do something like I'm going to do on that end and have a little bit of a bulge out. And then come this way. I don't mind how close it gets to the beach houses. You know, some people might say, well, it's weird having these factories next to these beach houses, but at some point everything's gonna have to join together. At some point, I don't want empty space like there is in real life. You know, in real life, these factories, and there might be a mile gap between the factories and the beach houses, because in the real world you've got enough space to leave a mile. In Minecraft you don't. You have to utilize the space. Things don't look good if you just leave them blank. You have to use what space you've got in a clever way, and I think, you know, leaving gaps is a bad idea. I really, really do. Okay, I don't know what I'm going to do with this back and the sides, but this is the sort of shape that we've got so far. I think that's a nice width. It's not too thin that you can't do anything with it. It's not so big that I'm not going to be able to fill it whenever we end up doing an interior to it, if we end up doing an interior to it. I'd like to do an interior to all the buildings here. I really would. The only trouble is I'm really not the best interior designer in Minecraft. It's not something that I've ever been... I wouldn't say, like, not interested in. I'm never as interested in doing interiors as I am doing exteriors. But, like if I get the chance and I have a really good idea for an interior... I'll do it, but until then, I sort of leave them, really. I don't think Minecraft really has all that much in the way of interior design, unfortunately. I think that there's a lot that's missing, and they're getting there. Like the new, the new terracotta blocks that they bought out pretty recently, or they're not actually like fully out yet, are they, I suppose? They're in a snapshot, they're not in an official release yet, but that's a good step in the right direction. It gives, obviously, that they were intended for interior use. They're not really intended for exterior use, and that's a great thing to see. I really, really like that they're sort of doing that kind of thing. We just need more interior style blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13? 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Good, right. Yeah, lighting is the thing that I always say. They need to add more interior lightings. We've got torch, glowstone, redstone lamp, and some other things that sort of give off light. But I want actual lamp models. I know we can get them modded, but I went lamp. What, you know, that it would be such a handy thing to have in vanilla. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Yeah, that's what I expected. 14, 15, 16, 17. I want 13, oops, on this last one. Yeah, I mean, what would be the harm of having, like, a little lamp that you can craft in survival? It would just be so handy to have. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. I do want 13 on this one. So it goes 13 on the left, 13 on the right, and then the middle one is larger. It's lovely. It lines up relatively well, I think. And then it's sticking out way too far. And then I think we pretty much just go square here. Maybe I drop this back by a couple more blocks. And then we come back this way. Extend this one out. I think I'll put a little bit of a little bulge in like that. I'll fill that block in, otherwise I might confuse some of you. And then do I do a bulge on this end? Or do I do a bulge on the other end? I think I'll do a bulge on this end. Or do we do the bulge of it? Or do we do both? Like, do I do it like that instead? Yeah, no, we'll do a double. We'll a double bulge. Okay, so it's big. It's a big floor plan. This obviously is going to take more than one episode, maybe even more than two episodes. But there are going to be some repeating patterns throughout. Obviously, you can tell by the way that I've laid out these bulges and stuff. That windows and stuff are going to be relatively the same size and shape down certain parts of the building. For these garage doors, I want to use... I've got an itchy nose. We're going to use iron blocks to look like big industrial. And then I want a yellow block. A yellow block, AJ? Why would you want a yellow block floor for? Well, I saw a pretty cool idea. I want... It needs to be 5x7. Which is why I made these garage doors 7 blocks wide. And we'll do all three of them. Because, I mean, why not? They need to be done. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Whoop, 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 whoop. And there. And on this one. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I always like to count to make sure that, like, I haven't made one for some stupid reason, 1 block wide or anything like that. And then what we're going to do is I'm going to go on this side. And I'm going to put 3 dots at the bottom. 3 dots up. And like that. 1. And then 3 dots at the bottom. This one here. That one there. That one there, that one there, that one there. Oops. 2? Is that a good 2? Can I do a better 2 than that? I don't think I can. I think that's about as good as 2 as you can get on that scale. And then 1. You go like that. No, 3. it doesn't go 1, 2, 1. 3 is an easy one. Oop, like that. Okay, so we've got 1, 2, 3 on the garages there. We'll dress the garages up a little bit. Obviously, we've got to have these going up these sides and over the top. That then makes the garage doors look like they're sitting back a block. Walls, cobblestone walls. I shouldn't really be doing this kind of detail this early on, but it just gives us a good idea. I'm going to put little cobblestone walls there. They look like little shutters, like little rails that sort of and lift the whole garage door up. Anything like cobblestone wall or trap doors and buttons, those kind of details, you should really do somewhat towards the end of a build. It's not as bad if you've got world edit, but if you don't have world edit and you put all those details in and then you want to make a really subtle change, like just move it over by 1 block, if you don't have world edit or you're doing it on console, for example, you then have to remove all that detail that you've done. Move it over by 1 block and then place them all back again, and it's just hard work that nobody wants to have. What have we got at the bottom there? I'm using that block. I do want a block something like that. I think I'm gonna do, like, I've got cobblestone and then sandstone. I think I want stone brick as the base of this one, and I think I want the foundation to be at different heights depending on the part of the building. I know we've done this brick, but it doesn't matter for me, fortunately. I'm going to select all the brick, change it all to stone brick. From there to there, replace brick with 98. Ta-da! And then I want the stone brick to be at different heights in certain areas. Like in the middle here, I want it to be higher. I think I want it to be 5 blocks high. Because there's going to be big old tunnels. Well, not tunnels, funnels. Tunnels. There's going to be big old funnels in front of these ones. Out the front here. 2 big tunnels, one in front of each part of this. 2, 3, 4, 5. And I might do the tunnels now so I can get a good idea on... If I do the tunnels now, it's going to limit how tall I can make the building. because if I do the tunnels, I can't really make the building taller than the funnels. If I do the building first, I can then sort of work out exactly where I want the funnels to go up to. I think that's a smarter way to do it. Okay, and then I want this part of the building, like the little T section, to be, I think, two blocks of foundation. So we're just going to run this around the edge. And then it's pretty much brick on top of that with the sandstone detail. I'm using the brick and the sandstone color palette again because it's very, how do you say, like old-timey, very classical. It looks like it's one of the first buildings that were built, or like a really old building that sort of hasn't, that's just barely sort of stood the test of time. And that's the sort of look that we want to have from these factories. They've sort of been going for ages, run by big, you know, families that have been passed down and kept running. That's the sort of thing I want. We've got this nice big front yard here for, you know, checker patterns and car park and stuff like that out the front. I don't know what I'm going to do for a wall or anything like that yet. That's not something that we need to worry about at the moment. Let's think about the height now. So we're going to grab our brick again. Brick. And we want this to go pretty high. Maybe we should even start with this part, to be honest. I'm going to do it here. And I'm going to continue this up. I don't know how many blocks. I'm just going to go up for the moment. And I'm going to have this one set one block behind. The same on this side. There. And here. Then I want one up the middle. Very similar to how our fire station ended up being. Then we want these here. And then the windows is sort of up to you guys how you'd want to do them. If you're building this along at home, you can do two sets of 3x2 windows. And then I was thinking something like that for the top. I think that looks really cool. Maybe something to set it back or pull it forward would be nice as well. Cobblestone walls, anything like that, I think would work. It does look okay, or even changing this clay to a different clay. I think that would be a better one. I think changing this to normal clay would work. Is that 159.9, isn't it? Yeah. Replace 159.9 with just clay. Gives a little bit of lightness to it. It might be too light. It's really hard to tell. I can't tell at the moment if I'm going to like it or not. And for the moment, I'm just going to go two blocks higher. Because I don't think I'm going to go along here. I might do. I mean, I might put it in. I might take that away, though. And I might just put some sort of brick top along there with some sort of sandstone accent like there is on the top of that building. I don't know yet. It's going to be tough. So that's the sort of thing that we're going to have there, there, and there on all three of those. And then the brick, this is super simple. This obviously side, there's nothing else that can go on here. It's going to go up to this height for the minute. It looks like that's going to be a pretty sensible height with brick as well for the factory. It's sort of a good height for the size of the building. I think it's pretty good. So for the moment, let's just make all of this brick. That runs around the entire sort of bulge here. And then there might be some detail that we can put in, some recesses, some extensions, things like that. And that one. Yeah, and then the funnel's going to go on the front here. I am taking inspiration by someone else's factory, by the way. But I'm just trying to make it improve upon it, you know, just use it for inspiration, improving product, put it to my building style, you know, put our little touches to blend in with the local area and things like that. Okay, I like that. And then the funnel goes in front here. Okay, and then for the funnel, what block do we want to use for the funnel? Do we want it a grey block? Do we want it a white block? Do we want it to look clean? Do we want it to look dirty? Sand could work. light grey wool could work. I do tend to stay away from wool, though. Ah! Sorted. Solved. It's like the perfect metal block. 1, 2, 3, like that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3. Little too big? Little too small? What do you think? Little too big? Let's go a little bit smaller. It's a real nice circle, but it might not be quite exact. If we go, we keep it with 5, but instead of doing 3 in the corner, we just do 1, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now at this size, I think I prefer, it's not quite as magnificent of a circle, but it does drop the funnel in by one block away from the edge of this corner. And before, it ended up being in line with it. And it looked very same old, you know. Doing it like this is actually going to sort of funnel our way towards the garage doors. Draw your eye towards it. You can still tell that it's a circle. Hopefully when we get the tunnels in, we're still going to be able to tell that it's a tunnel as well. I think that's probably the sensible size for it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1. To let you guys know, the funnels on the original picture, it's a lot bigger, the factory, by the looks. Everything is sort of on a bigger scale in some other, you know, bigger or smaller scale in other people's worlds, depending on what they're working with. But theirs is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, I would say. It's really hard to count because I can't see how many blocks it is, but I would say 6, 2, 1, 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I would say that. And as you can see, that would be an absolutely huge circle, way too big for our scale of our city. You know, I think people work on that scale when they don't have like these Flans vehicles, because obviously Minecraft cars, if you build them out of blocks, they end up being a lot bigger than they do than these models that we've got, because in Minecraft you physically can't make them any smaller than what they are sometimes. So yeah, I think that's why people then end up building their buildings larger, because they have no choice. It would look weird if the buildings were small and the cars were big, but for us it would look really weird. It would look really weird if the buildings were... Did I click the right side? I think I did. It would look really weird if the buildings were large and the cars were small. That would make no sense. So, yeah, you sort of got to build to what you have available. There we go. And there we go. What glass are we going to put in here? Just normal glass? White stained glass? Place air with 160. Yeah, I think that looks nice and clean. I could even do... This is an interesting one. Some of you might like, some of you might not like. As it's a factory, it's going to be a little bit dirty. Glass. So what if we mixed in just a little bit of grey panes? Just in like a couple of them. And it looks like the windows are just sort of a little bit, I don't know, coaly, like from the, from the funnels and stuff like that. You know, they haven't quite been cleaned 100%. I think we're going to try. We'll try it. I'll see what you guys say. And if you like it, then we'll keep it. If you don't like it, then we'll remove it. It's not a problem. Nothing's permanent, is it? Yeah, I think that's pretty interesting. I think that's a pretty cool idea. All right, and we'll just grab this to go in. Oops, in here. Copy. And paste. Oh. Nothing's ever easy. Well, that is all I've got time for today, unfortunately. Oops. Oh, it worked. Brickle apparently is the same as brick. That's all I got time for today. We've got actually a lot more than I thought we would done. Usually on a building like this, I'm very pleased if I just get the blueprint set out in the first episode. But we've got the blueprint, you know, the footprint, and some detail and some ideas on how we're going to move forward from here as well. So if you guys enjoyed it, hit that like button if you haven't already, and feel free to subscribe. We shall see you in the next episode.